Hey, YouTube. Monkey Joker. Back. Day 5. One Hit Wonders. Infinity Grooves here. Today, Crash Test Dummies. I had another song that I was going to do in right here, but then this one, as we was doing these, this one popped in my head, and I was like, "Nah, we got to do this one."
So I concurred.
We're doing Crash Test Dummies. But you know, the thing about this song is it was a hit, and you know it was a hit because Weird Al, did a song. Yep. So you know you made it if Weird Al does one of your songs.
That's what I was about to say. You know you made it big time with a song when Weird Al does a parody to it.
But then it disappeared.
Yeah.
So let's get into this one.
Accident and caught and come to school, but when he finally came back, his hair had turned from black into bright white. He said that it was from when the cousin smashed his
actually listened to this entire album. It was God Shuffled His Feet is the name of the album. I'm trying to think. I got it pulled up. 93.
Yeah, if it sounded like that grunge era.
Yeah, it was 93, but I liked like 5 or 6 different songs off this album. I enjoyed it. And the first album that came out, they had a song called Superman, which kind of made the thing, but I don't think it was that high on the charts. If it even made a chart, but this is the only song that I know that it really got up there. But liked it. I liked this song.
His voice is kind of. I mean, his voice is cool. I mean, he's got like an Eddie Vedder sound. If you listen to like certain parts of Jeremy, he starts getting deeper, or some of the parts of the other songs he has. I guess it's maybe that grunge era.
Like I said, I thought this album was pretty good, but this is the only one that really got on the chart. So let's keep it going.
Mm-hmm.
You know, how do you, when you write in your chorus, let's just make it. But it fits with the song, though. Yeah. You know, it does fit with that song.
I mean, it's got a great message. I mean, it's okay to be an outcast, and it's okay to be different, but it's not okay to be picked on like the girl that had all the birthmarks. And, yeah. I mean, you, everybody's different for a certain reason.
You could tell that the kid at the end, probably he get picked on by his parents.
Yeah.
The way they were looking at him, and he was looking back at them.
Yeah.
So, I can't think of that. I want to say it's Brad something, but I can't think of the singer's name.
It looks like Scott Stapp. A little bit.
I don't know.
But I know it ain't him.
Let's finish it out. Just a low key, a melody, you know. But, I mean, good song. It was Brad Roberts. I knew it was Brad something, but I couldn't remember his last name, but it's Roberts. And I don't know anything else that they've done since the 90s. And they're from Winnipeg. They're from Canada. And I'm trying to see how many albums they have out. Whoa.
One.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. They got 9. I had the Ghost That Haunt Me, God Child From My Feet, and A Worm's Life. I had those three, and then, you know.
They ghosted.
But catchy little tune. Good mellow.
I mean, it reminds me of that grunge era. I mean, just the sound. I mean, yeah. I like that era.
And if Weird Al does your song.
Yeah, you're pretty good.
You did something.
Yeah, you did something special.
That was Crash Test Dummies. We're Infinity Grooves. Subscribe, like, and comment. Come join us on this journey. Peace.